individuals affiliated with a political organization.
For 9 years, Senator Tom Bakk led the DFL caucus in the Minnesota Senate, was the go-to guy on where Democrats stood. Now he's leaving, along with fellow Iron Ranger David Tomassoni, to create an independent group.
Really just a matter of trying to do as good a job possible for the people in our district and for the state.
Just last week, the GOP-controlled Senate elected Tomassoni as its president, so he'll have the gavel presiding over sessions. Both he and Bakk have been promised they'll get to chair a Senate committee, something they couldn't do as DFLers.
I think that if we can get people to come together and try and make decisions that are not only good for our district, but good for the state, that's what the people want us to do.
The GOP was on track to have a one-seat advantage for the next 2 years, but now Republicans will have a 34 to 31 seat edge with two independents who can swing either way.
And the ones that we want to mine on the Iron Range in the non-ferrous area.
The Iron Rangers broke with most Democrats on copper-nickel mining and the Enbridge Line 3 pipeline replacement project. And earlier this year, Susan Kent challenged Bakk for DFL leader and won that title. Senator Bakk had heart surgery earlier this year. He said he spent part of his recovery looking out at a lake and wondering what he wanted his legacy to be.
I've worked really, really hard at the legislature to improve the lives of people. But what I don't want to be remembered at is just another partisan hack. I want to be remembered as somebody that was courageous to do things that led to more prosperity in our communities.
The two Iron Rangers say it's too early to say what party banner they'll run under in 2022. For Care 11 News, I'm John Croman.